Opinion piece. I could likely be getting massively fucking worked right now. This could be the biggest work of all time, but if it is, it's fucking stupid.
Get this bum out of here, will you? Just get this bum out of here already.
I apologize, Mr. Johnson. The Rock committed a Severus Snape tier long-term work at the expense of his own reputation simply to save WrestleMania. With the advent of all the crazy news and CM Punk's injury throwing WrestleMania's plans into a tizzy, The Rock came in, and you know what he did? He took the bullet. My God, this is now the second time I have been completely wrong about a professional wrestler and his reputation, and I could not be happier. Because truthfully, wrestling really is at its best when we don't know shit. The Rock was not lying when he said he was a long gamer. Because think about it, every single conceivable path, we all questioned it. The Rock comes into the TKO board. He gives all these interviews and he says he's a long gamer. And he puts out these delusional Instagram posts. Oh yeah, me and Cody are buddies. We're hype. I'm hype beast for WrestleMania. Long game. And he comes in 2 months before WrestleMania. And then Triple H begins his work. Triple H and The Rock colluded for one of the greatest six-dimensional works in the history of the wrestling business. Think about it. They leaned into every single conceivable stereotype about The Rock, every single conceivable stereotype about Hollywood, and they worked the fuck out of me and everyone on the internet, to the point where they got, we want Cody to be the fifth largest trend in the entire world. Trace back the events. Dave Meltzer is over here yapping, just like he always does, about this insider information he thinks he has, when the truth of the matter is, he's just like the rest of us. He's just like me. A fucking mark.
Whenever I was trying to find out what was going on, the one question that nobody could answer for me was, why did Cody Rhodes win the Royal Rumble? Because it's like, well, if Rock was going to wrestle against Roman Reigns, and Punk was going to wrestle against Seth Rollins, where does Cody fit in?
And once this work set in and the deep existential depression had begun, this press conference takes place. And The Rock comes out there with a microphone in hand, and he shows us all why he's still a great one. Mr. Johnson, to you I apologize. But at the same time, I don't think I owe him an apology. I think this is the exact reaction he wanted from everyone. Because this not only is one of the greatest works in history, this is the greatest heel turn of The Rock's career and possibly of all time. Watch him come out on that stage. Watch him milk that reaction, the boos, the disdain as he's about to hit his finales, and he takes off those glasses and he looks at the sea of marks. This is what the fucking business has come to. They're rejecting the great one. I'm The Rock, goddammit. He milked every single one of the stereotypes around the guy. Every single one of the conventional wisdoms about the guy. Oh, he came in to destroy Black Adam. He's coming in to destroy WWE. And now, with Vince McMahon well and truly gone, I'm thinking we need a new heel authority figure. And I think they alluded to that at the end of this press conference when Triple H and The Rock had their stare down. I'm thinking we're in for some high cinema. I'm thinking we are in for a long game. I'm thinking we're in to the greatest fusion of Hollywood rock and the heel chairman's gimmick. I'm thinking we're in for the people's GM, and I can't wait to see how this goes. WrestleMania 40 is well and truly saved, and it's thanks to Triple H, Cody Rhodes, and the great one, The Rock. Unquestionably, the greatest work of all time. He worked me into a fucking shoot seethe. I'm so happy about this. They worked the dirt sheets into a tizzy. They worked me into a tizzy and all of you in the comments section into a tizzy. And I genuinely could not be happier. Triple H has now ushered in the Neo kayfabe era. The way you bring back kayfabe. Just work the dirt sheets. Just work the news media. Beyond the dirt sheets. You had mainstream coverage of this. Not only did they work Dave Meltzer, Sean Ross Sapp, PW Insider, and all of the wrestling dirt sheets into a tizzy, they worked the mainstream media. They worked the legacy media into a shoot, which to me just proves don't get your news from there, guys. Don't get any news from any of these people. Because they're just about as credible as a Dave Meltzer. And listen, I don't hate Dave. Dave's the king of the, he's the Turbo Spurg, the king of the autists, and I appreciate him for that. And I love the historical journalism the guy does, but he clearly doesn't know shit either. God, what a turn of events. WrestleMania 40 is well and truly saved. Because Cody and Roman 4, it's on. And Cody Bros, Story Bros, TKO Bros, Kino Bros, we're about to fucking eat. To Triple H, the cerebral assassin, I bow the fuck down, for I have been worked. I'm still on the lookout for that Ari Emanuel cat, though, because I am from Chicago, and us Chicagoans know the Emanuel family all too well. But with the conclusion of the press conference and the kicking off of the road to WrestleMania, this proves definitively that no matter what you do, no matter who you work, no matter who you make seethe, as long as you keep it Kino, life is cinema.